Yes, our God is great. God is great. We have to always glorify him because he is so great. And we cannot stop glorifying his name. We cannot stop praising his name. He is great. We must always glorify his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My name is Brother Philip, and I welcome all of you to Back to the Bible Way ministry. And we are going to continue with these things as far as God gives us breath. So please, I hope you are going to listen to this program day in and day out, because God is great and we need to share the word of God together always. We shall play one of our songs, and then in the process I'll begin the program as usual. So I hope everybody is going to listen to us carefully. I have about 30 minutes to speak, and after that we are going to give time for questions. So get ready with your questions, even from last week, no matter what, from last week up till today, whatever we might be discussing today, you have the chance also to ask any question, no matter what. So we are going to play.
Clap your hands, everybody. Come on.
After that.
If God's been faithful, then sing along with us. Everybody say faithful.
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 Faithful,
faithful is our God.
Faithful is our God.
Come on, all over the world.
Faithful.
Say faithful.
Faithful,
faithful,
faithful
is our God.
Is our God.
Come on, say faithful.
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 Faithful,
faithful,
faithful
is our God.
Is our God.
Yes, he is. Come on, say faithful.
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 Faithful,
faithful, is our God.
Faithful is our God.
I'm reaping the harvest.
I'm reaping the harvest God promised me.
Take back what the devil stole from me.
And
I rejoice today.
For
I shall recover it all.
Yes, I rejoice today.
Yes, our God is faithful. We have to glorify him. We have to glorify him.
Yes.
We have to glorify his name always. Our God is great. We have to glorify his name. What do you think about that? You yourself. That's right. You have to think about that. Glorify God. God is great. As I said, we have about 30 minutes for discussion, and after that, we are going to go through. We are going to listen to your questions. So please bear in mind that you have access to ask any question that you like. So be ready. Even from last week's speech, which I made, you still have the chance to ask any question. I'm going to have a recap of last week's discussion.
Everybody
Yes, our God is great. Our God is great. We have to glorify His name. We thank God for this gathering, this program again. This is Choice FM Radio, and you are tuning in to Choice FM Radio, as I'm saying. But welcome you, everybody, to back to the Bible Way Gospel Ministry. And we are dealing with a lot of subtopics, and in the process, we try to delve into the scriptures and see what God has for us. And the brother was even saying, Brother 007 was saying that back to the Bible Way, we don't know what we mean by back to the Bible Way. There's a need to go back to the Bible Way. And so, as we have already discussed, we need to go back to the Bible Way. And so that is why we have our ministry, the title of our ministry as Back to the Bible Way, because God has something for us as individuals, as Christians, which is hidden in the scriptures, and we need to delve into the scriptures. So let us continue to delve into it. Let us continue to study the Bible, and then we know the will of God, and be able to please Him. Hallelujah. My name is Brother Philip. Once again, as I told you, and you are welcome to Choice FM Radio, and this is Back to the Bible Way Ministry. I would like us to see what we discussed last week, and then from there we continue with today's program, which would also be a continuation of the same topic. Last week, if you could remember very well, we were able to talk about the mystery of God, or God's plan for redeeming man. The mystery of God, or God's plan for redeeming man. And that we were able to open to certain passages of the scriptures, which were able to help us to know what we mean by the mystery of God. God, who, according to the scriptures, has His own plan and foreknowledge. Some years back, before even He created the world, He foreknew everything. God had knew that man would fall from sin. I mean, from His grace, I will say that. Man will fall from His grace. And for that matter, there was a need for Him to have a plan whereby after the fall of man, He will bring man back to Himself. And so this is what we talked about last week, and we termed it as the mystery of God. That is God's plan for redeeming man. And we were able to define what the word mystery means. We realized that the mystery is something that is the knowledge that is withheld. Knowledge that is withheld. God had the knowledge, had a foreknowledge that mankind would fall or would sin against Him after He has created us. So there was a need for Him to have a plan before even the creation. And then after that, we will come back to Him, that through His plan. Now, I think last week there was a question of whether man is a Christian can sin or not. And to be honest with you, I think there was an answer to that, but I would like us to draw attention to this again, that yes, if we claim that we do not sin, we deceive ourselves, because that's what the Bible says. And so do not let us think that we Christians or people of God are sinless. We are sinful beings, no matter what, no matter the fact that the blood of Jesus Christ has cleansed us from all unrighteousness. So long as we are in the flesh, even though we do not encourage ourselves to sin, but we have to understand that, yes, there's by all means, there's the possibility of we sinning against God. And that is why the Bible says that if we sin against God, He is perfect and He's honest to forgive us of our sins, if we are able also to what? To confess our sins to Him. And that is why the book of John said, if we say we do not sin, we make Him a liar. We make God a liar, because God knows that we are sinful beings and we are not perfect. And for that matter, we cannot say we do not sin, even though, like I'm saying, we do not have to encourage ourselves to sin, but still sin is still around us. That is why the Bible says, if we confess ourselves, our sins to one another, or if we confess our sins, God is faithful to forgive us of all our sins. So I would like us to draw that conclusion, and then we move on to today's Listen, as I said last week, we dealt about this God's plan for redeeming man in many ways by opening to certain scriptures of the Bible, certain passages of the Bible, whereby we were able to know that God had his plan for mankind. We opened passages which showed us, for instance, the book of Ephesians chapter 1 verse 9, Ephesians chapter 3 verse 9, 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 7 through 9 through 10, and Colossians chapter 1 verse 27, and then Colossians chapter 2 verse 2. All these talk about God's advanced plan for sinful man. So it's something that we cannot avoid, or we cannot argue that God does not have a plan for us. He has a plan for us to bring us back to himself. This is what we mean by God's plan for redeeming man. So as we move on, or as long as we are on this earth, we need to know that there's a plan for God. There's God's plan for us to redeem us. And so we do not let this opportunity pass by. We do not need to let this opportunity pass by, because if this opportunity passes by and we die, we are doomed. So let us bear that in mind as children of God. God is great, and we must always know that so long as he is God, and so long as he is the greatest being, and so long as he is the most powerful being, and he has that plan for us, we have nowhere to escape if we do not go according to his plan. So let us bear that in mind. Today we are going to continue with this same thing, but it's kind of a development plan, or I would say that a step forward, which I have subtitled God's systematic plan for man, as narrated by Philip the Evangelist. I'm talking about Philip in the Bible, Philip of the book of Acts chapter 6 and chapter 7. We read from the book of Acts chapter 6, whereby this man Philip, who was an evangelist, was full of the Holy Spirit. Chapter 6 and verse 8. Stephen, I'm talking about the evangelist Stephen, who was full of the Holy Spirit. He says, and Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among people. I'm talking about the evangelist Stephen, who was full of faith and power. And he said, the Bible says, he did great wonders and miracles among people. This is an introductory part concerning what he did, and then the narrative he gave concerning God's plan for redeeming man. So I want us to bear in mind that the man Stephen in the book of Acts chapter 6 and then chapter 7 is being introduced as one who was full of the Holy Ghost, and then he started to give a narrative about God's plan for redeeming man. And this is what I would like us to go into today. As you listen to me now, we are going to concentrate on the book of Acts chapter 6, chapter 7, to give us the full story about God's plan for redeeming man. And after that, if there's any question, as I said, you have the chance to ask. All right, God bless you. Shall we continue? So we go to chapter 7 of the book of Acts, because bear in mind, we have already read the book of Acts chapter 6 and verse 8, which says, Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. Why am I calling the name Stephen? Like I'm saying, he gave some narratives about God's plan for redeeming man in chapter 7. So chapter 6 verse 8 is an introductory part towards the man Stephen. So let us continue in chapter 7. Then the high priest, then said the high priest, are these things so? This is a question to Stephen. Stephen, who was full of the Holy Spirit, started to talk about what he has seen and what he knows about God and what he knows about Jesus Christ, because he kind of was full of the Holy Spirit such that he couldn't stop talking. Remember, some time ago, in the beginning part of this program, I said we need to study the Bible to show ourselves approved unto God. A workman that needs not to be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of God, or dividing the word of truth. So Stephen was not ashamed of the gospel. So no matter where he was ready to preach. And so he started to preach, and that ended him, or that led him to being accused of by the elders and the scribes and the Pharisees. In the book of Acts chapter 6, the same chapter 6, when you start from verse 12, or even from verse 11, and this Sabon and said it, then these Sabon men which said, we have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and against God. You see, they were accusing him falsely, that he was speaking falsely against, or blasphemous words against Moses and against God. So chapter 7 verse 1 starts with a question from the high priest. Are these things so? And so from verse 2, here's a case Stephen got the chance, the opportunity. I think within himself, he would say, God, I thank you for allowing these people to ask me even this question. And this is the time for me to do what? To expose or to bring out your mystery, your plan of salvation, your plan to redeem man. So God, please give me the strength and the energy and the boldness to speak. Hallelujah. So here comes Stephen starting his message. Then verse 2 says, and he said, men and brethren and fathers, hearken, men and brethren and fathers, hearken. The God of glory appeared unto our father Abraham when he was in Mesopotamia, before he dwelt in Charan, and said unto him, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred, and come into the land which I shall show thee. Hallelujah. Here Stephen has started to talk about where God called Abraham and told him about what to do. Move from where you are to a new place where I'm going to show you. So they started the plan of God, or the God's plan to redeem man, have started from the man Abraham. Remember very well that last week I said something about the fact that man sinned against God in the Garden of Eden. Man sinned against God in the Garden of Eden. And God, who foreknows everything, had in mind to bring man back to himself. Because after man sinned against God, according to Isaiah chapter 59, verse 1 and 2, it says, the hand of God of the Lord is not so short that he cannot reach us, or nor his ears kind of close, or he's like deaf, whereby he cannot hear whatever he will say. No, God can hear us, God can reach us, but he says, but our iniquities or our sins have hidden us from God, whereby whatever we say, he wouldn't hear. That's sad. And so there was a need for God to bring man back to himself, because due to our sins, we have fallen from God. And since due to our sins, we have fallen from God, there was a need for God to find a way to bring us back to himself again, because he created us and he loved us and he does not want any of us to perish. Hallelujah. So the book of Acts chapter 7 is telling us more about what God has for us in terms of his plan for saving man, or God's plan for salvation towards man. So verse 3 says, and he and said unto him, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred, and come into the land which I shall show thee. So it was God who told Abraham to leave where he was and then go to wherever God will show him. And then what happened? If God says I should move from here to another place, what next? And if we read from verse 5, he says, and he gave him none inheritance in it, no, not so much as to set his foot on. Yet he promised that he would give it to him for a possession, and to his seed after him, when as yet he had no child. Hallelujah. Abraham had no child at that time, but God gave, God said, the Bible says, even though he didn't have any child and he had not had any inheritance, but God said, you are going to possess, I'm going to give you a promise of having a possession of a land. But then, even at that time, he didn't have any child. So, and the promise was to Abraham and his seed. Abraham and his seed. When we read the book of Galatians, chapter 3 and verse 16, the Bible says, the promise that was given to Abraham and his seed is true. But the seed was not as many as whereby he's going to say, and to thy seeds as of many, but unto seed, and to thy seed which is Christ. So the seed was Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. But then the Bible needed, there was a need for God to let Abraham have a child, because he was saying at that time that he didn't have any child, to have a child. And after the child will be born, and when the child is born, then the generation must continue, which would also help to kind of let God's plan to redeem man take a shape, because God needed, there was a need for God to let his plan of salvation pass through state by state through human beings until the appointed time. Hallelujah. So verse 6 of the book of Acts chapter 7 says that and God spoke on this wise, that his seed should sojourn in a strange land, and that they should bring them into a bondage and treat them evil for 400 years. This is what God was telling Abraham. I'm going to give you this land, but before I give you this land, your seeds shall possess this land. Your seeds shall be enslaved, shall sojourn into another land, and that is a strange land. And they shall be treated badly for 400 years. We know all these things. We know all these things. But this is just something that kind of helps us. It kind of strengthens us as we go back to kind of listen to these things. And to draw our attention that it was in God's plan. In God's plan to redeem man. For his children Israel to be enslaved in a strange land. That is in the land of Egypt. Yes. So, chapter 7 of the book of Acts and verse 8 says, and he gave him the covenant of circumcision. That is, God gave Abraham the covenant of circumcision. And so Abraham begot Isaac and circumcised him the 8th day. And Isaac begot Jacob, and Jacob begot the 12 patriarchs. Hallelujah. So you see, there are certain names being mentioned of. Why are these names being mentioned of? God is mentioning these names for a certain reason. These people whose names were being mentioned, or whose names were mentioned, were part of God's plan to redeem man. They were in God's plan. It's just like a building, whereby there are a lot of materials needed to make the structure, the building structure, complete. So God's plan to redeem man needed to take step by step. And so After Abraham, we had the man, or the patriarch, Isaac. And the Bible says, Isaac also had Jacob. And then Jacob also had the 12 patriarchs, or the 12 fathers. Patriarchs means fathers. So, this is what we see here. That God's plan to redeem man has passed on from Abraham, through the patriarch, through the patriarchs, that is the fathers, that's the 12 tribes of Israel. But it was a step by step account, or it was a step by step approach. I would rather say that, in the sense that, one, Abraham was selected by God. The Bible says, because Abraham was so faithful to God, he was called the friend of God. Hallelujah. He was called the friend of God. And then, when Abraham, who had no child, was told to move from where he was, that's from his father's place, to another place, he did not shake up his head. He rather agreed to God and then went to where God had promised to give to him. And so Over there, God helped Abraham to have a child by name Isaac. We know that he earlier on had Ishmael. We can talk about that later on. But if anybody has a question still, you can bring it out. But what I'm trying to say is, Ishmael was born first, but let us bear in mind that Ishmael was not the promised son or the promised child. So God did not pass his promise through Ishmael, but he passed his promise through Isaac, who was a legitimate child of Abraham. In a sense that it was Abraham and Sarah, his real wife, who had Isaac. But it was Abraham and Hagar who had the child Ishmael, and he was not the promised child, a child of Abraham, or God did not promise his coming. Okay. So we continue to see that God's plan to redeem man has come to a point where the 12 tribes or the patriarch, the patriarch's name have been made mention of. And if the patriarch's name have been made mention of, let us see what the narrative is shown here in the book of Acts chapter 7. Reading from verse 17. Acts chapter 7 and verse 17. It says, the man who gave that narrative says, "But when the time of the promise drew nigh, which God had sworn to Abraham, the people grew and multiplied in Egypt." God had promised Abraham that his people are going to have going to enslave in a certain land, or going to be going to sojourn in a land, a strange land, and they'll be tortured for 400 years. So verse 17 is telling us of getting nearer or getting nigh of the promise which God had sworn to Abraham. He says, "But when the time of the promise drew nigh," that is drew near, "God, which had sworn to Abraham, the people, God, which has sworn to Abraham, the people grew and multiplied in Egypt." So, because the time was getting nearer, the people of Israel, or the children of Israel, those days they did not know that they were even called Israel, but still they were Israelites, because they came from Jacob, who was Israel. Now these children multiplied in Egypt. How come? Remember that the patriarchs, Abraham had Isaac, Isaac had Jacob, Jacob had the patriarchs. The patriarchs are the 12 tribes of Israel. But before these children of Israel went into Egypt, let us bear in mind that one of the children of Jacob, whose name was Joseph, was sold by his brethren into Egypt. And it was there that later on his family members, that's his father and his siblings, came down to Egypt and stayed there with him until Jacob died. And after that, according to the Bible, here's what you were saying, that later on, when the promise of God drew nigh or drew nearer, God, who had sworn to Abraham, and now the people or the children of Israel started to grow, or they multiplied in their numbers. And as they multiplied in their numbers, there was a man whose name was what? Moses. But then, he had not been born. But before he was born, the king of Egypt decided to destroy these people, especially the male children of any Hebrew, so that they would not conquer them, or they would not override them in the near future. But we know that God, whose promise or whose purpose must be accomplished, has his own way. Hallelujah. And so when in the process of they're trying to destroy the children of Israel, in the process a child was born whose name was Moses. And it was, as we know, it was this Moses who was able, by the hand of God and by the power of God, to take the children of Israel from the hand of Pharaoh into the land of Canaan. But let us bear in mind, the book of Acts, chapter 7 and verse 30. Acts chapter 7, verse 30. Now, verse 30 says, "And when 40 years were expired, there appeared unto him in the wilderness of Mount Sinai, and an angel of the Lord in flame of fire, and fire in bush, in a bush. This is about Moses. What I'm trying to say is this: Moses was born, and Moses was brought up in Pharaoh's palace, and then he was educated so well that he was able to know that he wasn't an Egyptian, but he was an Israeli. And so, for that matter, he saw what his people were going through, and it was so painful to him. So what happened was, if you remember very well, there was a time even one Israeli and one Egyptian were fighting. Moses went and helped the Israeli and killed the Egyptian. Another time came when Moses saw that two Israelis were fighting, and he wanted to go and then part them or bring peace, and that also brought an explosion. Do you want to kill us as you killed the other Egyptian? That was a question from one of the Israelis. And so Moses, knowing that what he did has leaked out, fled from that place, until verse 30 of Acts chapter 7 says that, and when 40 years were expired, there appeared unto him, that is unto Moses, in the wilderness of Mount Sinai, and an angel of the Lord in a flame of fire in a bush. So Moses fled to a place, and where he went to a man by the name Jethro, and to kind of take care of his sheep so that he'd be able to earn living. And it was there in the bush where God appeared unto him to go back to Egypt and take or remove the people of Israel from the hands of Pharaoh. Let us listen here carefully. Moses then had the challenge to go back and redeem Israel from the hands of Pharaoh. Verse 37 says something here which is interesting. Thus it says, this is that Moses which said unto the children of Israel, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up unto your father, unto you and your brethren like unto me, him shall ye hear. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Now let's listen again, please. He says, this is that Moses which said unto the children of Israel, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up unto you of your brethren like unto me, him shall ye hear. Hallelujah. This is the Moses who said something about somebody. And who was that person? You see, the man who is giving the narrative in the book of Acts chapter 7 is trying to tell the fathers or the scribes and the Pharisees who had met, who were trying to accuse him that he was blaspheming against Moses and God, was trying to explain to them that this same Moses you are saying that I'm blaspheming, this same Moses said something about Jesus Christ. He said God has said he would raise up a prophet like unto me, Moses, and when that prophet comes, you shall listen to him. Hallelujah. So Moses was trying to draw the attention of the listeners or the audience that God prophesied, or God spoke through him, Moses, that he was going to raise up a prophet like him, Moses. So whenever that prophet comes, we should listen to that prophet. Who am I not to listen to that prophet? And who is that prophet? It's the man Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we see that God's plan for redeeming man, God's scheme of redeeming man or bringing man back to himself, has come to a point where we have reached, where Moses' name has been mentioned, and Moses also made mention of a prophet whom the Lord also would raise from among the children of Israel, and whom he is the one whom we should listen to, and he is the man Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So with this, we see that God's plan to redeem man has reached a certain stage, which is very, very beautiful. Lord willing, next week, because I do not want us to kind of rush and do not know what to do, and be able to, I would rather like us to be able to digest the whatever God has for us, so that we have time also for discussions. So in this wise, we'll be able to know what God wants us to do. At this time, because of that, I would like us to end this conversation here and give chance for anybody who has a question to ask, so that we kind of give answers to that, or we open the scriptures to give answers. So let us see what we have read so far. God, who had his plan to redeem man, chose the man Abraham from the beginning, because God knew that because man has sinned against God, against him, there's a need for him to bring man back to himself, because he loves us. He created us not in vain. He created us to kind of have that love for us. He loved us so much. That is why he created us. And for that matter, even if we have sinned against him and we have fallen from him, he had a way to bring us back to himself. Hallelujah. And in bringing us back to himself, he had to make a plan. And this is a plan, that the man Abraham was chosen from among his family to go to another land, and that land was a promised land to Abraham and his seed. And so God, at his appointed time, yes, led Israel into the land of Egypt, and then he led Israel out of the land of Egypt through the man Moses. But before Moses even was born, Abraham had Isaac, Isaac had Jacob, Jacob had the 12 tribes of Israel, out of which, out of whom Joseph was born, and through Joseph, all the children of Israel migrated into Egypt for them to be enslaved for 400 years. So with this, when Moses was born, and he was also charged to go and pick the children of Israel, or take the children of Israel from Egypt, this Moses, after having taken Israel from Egypt, instructed the children of Israel to listen carefully, that God would bring a prophet like unto him, Moses. And when that prophet comes, they should listen to him. Let us bear this in mind. And bear in mind that our program is Back to the Bible Way, and the subtopic is God's plan for redeeming man. So if it is Back to the Bible Way, let us know that whatever, whether it be question, or whether it be Bible, whether it be preaching, or whatever message we have, should be the Bible way. The question you may be asking should be the Bible way, because we want to give Bible way answers. So may the Lord bless you, and Lord willing, we are going to continue with this program, so that we be able to know the next stage, when Christ came, when Christ came, and what he has for us, and what we are supposed to do as fellow Christians or as followers of Jesus Christ, so that we have eternal life. May the Lord bless us and keep us, and so that we'll be able to know his will and follow it accordingly. It's up to us to ask questions. The doors are open now. Now let us remember that this is Choice FM Radio. So we need to listen carefully, that no matter what, God is Jesus Christ is a savior. We haven't dealt with that so much. We have come to the point where Moses was saying that God is going to raise up a prophet like unto him, Moses. We have to listen to him. And so the doors are open for questions. So please call us, so that we be able to give answers to any question that you may have. And from there, we glorify our God. To God be the glory. And then we thank you for whatever we have listened to this evening. My name is Brother Philip, as I said, and this is Back to the Bible Way Ministry. The doors are open for questions. So any person has the chance to call the number 347-663-8638. Number again, 347-663-8638. The chance is open. The door is open, please. May God bless you. God is great, and we have to glorify his name always. We have to glorify his name. We have to know that he loves us and he doesn't hate us, but it's the devil who wants us to be lost. And for that matter, He does not want us to know the will of God and to be able to be saved. So bear that in mind and be bold enough to ask any question, because the doors are open for questions, and we will open the scriptures to give answers. Remember, this is Back to the Bible Way Ministry, and you are tuning in to Choice Radio FM. We have to rejoice in the Lord because God is great. And this is Choice FM Radio. And you are welcome to Back to the Bible Way Ministry. Please bear in mind that we have the chance to ask any question that we have. And so feel free, be bold, and ask any question. Let us open the Bible, and then be able to know what God wants us to know. And then be saved in the end. Let us bear that in mind. Doors are open for questions.
Faithful is our God. Come on, all over the world. Say faithful. Faithful is our God.
Yes, our God is faithful. God is faithful. We have to know that. Whatever He has said, He will do it. And that is why through Moses He said, God would bring us a prophet like unto me. When He comes, we have to listen to Him. God, who said this, is so faithful. He has to accomplish that promise.
Take back what the devil stole from me. And I rejoice today. I shall recover it all. Yes, I rejoice today.
God is faithful. Let us recognize that. We cannot say God is not faithful. And He is a loving God. He is a loving God. So let us know His will. And then we go according to that. If we say we do not sin, we deceive ourselves. If we say we do not need God, we deceive ourselves. So please, feel free. And then let us see what we can do to please our God. Feel free and ask your questions. Because He is faithful. And very soon, Brother Vibes will come here with his beautiful songs to give us all whatever he has to kind of uplift our spirit. So let us bear that in mind also. Tune in. But still, I have ample time for you so that you have the chance to ask your question. This is Brother Philip. Thank you. Okay. We let us read the book of 1 John chapter 1 and verse 8. I am still trying to explain to the sister or the lady who asked that question last week, and this is in the book of First John chapter 1 and verse 8. John has a lot of messages for us concerning sin, so let us listen. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. Verse 9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, that's verse 10, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. So please let us bear that in mind. This is another a continuation of the answer to the lady who asked this question concerning people or Christians who if we can sin or if we sin or not. So please bear that in mind. The Bible says, if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. Do not and never say that we have no sin. We are Christians, yes, but we have sin. We do sin. One day, one way or the other, we sin against God. And somebody even says, sometimes we sin unknowingly. Yes, we cannot say we don't sin. We do sin, even though we do not need to kind of encourage ourselves to sin, because Paul was asking, what shall we do? Or what shall we say? Shall we live in sin that grace may abound? So that's the other side of the coin. Because grace is abound, floating, we do not have to stay in sin. Yes, we do not. But that doesn't mean that we are sinful beings. We are sinless beings. We are sinful beings. We are not sinless beings. Let us bear that in mind. And so he says in verse 9 again, 1 John chapter 1, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. That is to say, if I accept that I have sinned against God, or I have sinned against my human being, and I confess my sin, God is faithful and just to forgive me of my sins. The same thing applies to you. And verse 10 says, if we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar. So if you or I say that I do not sin, or you do not sin, you haven't sinned, you make God a liar. You see, there are a lot of things which I would like us to consider, or we are going to discuss in the process of this program as time goes by. Those things are certain things which we human beings do, or we say, or we teach, that makes God a liar. Let us bear this in mind. If we say that we have not sinned, we make God a liar. On the other hand, if we teach certain things that are not in conformity with the scriptures, we make God also a liar. Let us bear all these things in mind. The same, 1 John. Same 1 John chapter 2 and verse 1. My little children, this is right eye unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sins, we have an advocate, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. Hallelujah. Now here is the case. My little children, that's John, 1 John chapter 2 and verse 1. My little children, this is right eye unto you, that ye sin not. In other words, I'm writing these things to you so that you do not sin. Then he says, and if any man sins, meaning that there's a possibility of somebody to sin, even though he has written this letter to them so that they do not sin. But there is the possibility that some of them would sin. Why? Because we are human beings. And if any man sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. Hallelujah. So in case by mistake, or in case I sin against God, there's somebody who would help me out. So why do we say that we do not sin? We cannot say that we do not sin, but we don't have to encourage ourselves in sinning too. That's the point. All right, another point. And it says, and he is a propitiation for our sins. Jesus Christ is a propitiation of our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. So see, ours, that's we Christians, and the whole world, even if somebody is not a Christian. So Christ is there for Christians because we sin, and Christ is also there for non-Christians because they are in sin. So see the point there. We do sin. We cannot say we do not sin or that we have no sin. Another verse of 1 John chapter 2, verse 4. And he says, "He that said, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him." Any person who says he knows God and does not keep the law or the commandments of God is a liar. So if you are a Christian, if you say you are a Christian and you don't keep the commandments of God, you are a liar. And if you are a liar, or if I'm a liar, then I sin. You see, that confirms that we do sin. We do sin. So let us bear all these things in mind, so that God would rather forgive us of all our sins and keep us from all what? Unrighteousness. Hallelujah. So still, I said the chance is there for anybody who wants to ask a question to ask. Other than that, like I said, next week, Lord willing, we are going to continue with this program. We are going to continue with Back to the Bible Way ministry, and under the subtopic, God's plan for redeeming man, and in which we are going to know the stage where we have reached and where we are going to end. Because, like I said, God loves mankind so much. He loves you, he loves me. He does not want anybody to perish. God doesn't want anybody to perish. And so, in case I do not know that God loves me, at least today I've known it. And in case you also do not know that God loves you, you have known that God loves you. That is why he has his plan to redeem me and his plan to redeem you. With this, what shall we do? What shall we do? Let us continue to study the scriptures, and God would help us to understand his scriptures and be able to get us saved. May he bless us as we continue to worship him. May he bless us as we continue to study his scriptures. And let us bear in mind that there's a need for us not to swerve from the Bible. We don't have to swerve at all from the Bible. We have to go according to the Bible, stick to the Bible, and be able to have that blessings which he has for us. May the Lord bless us and keep us throughout our lifetime. In Jesus' name, amen. At this time, shall we pray? We shall pray at this time, and then we allow Brother Vibe to come and continue with his beautiful songs for us to kind of encourage us too. Shall we pray? Our dear God and our Father, we once again thank you for your mercies. Father, we thank you for what you have done for us, and especially for having revealed to us that you, Father, you love us so much. And for that matter, even though we sin against you, from the Garden of Eden through our patriarch Adam and his spouse, and as such you took us from the Garden of Eden, you drove man from the Garden of Eden, but still you had in mind to bring us back to yourself, out of which you were able, Father, to select the patriarch Abraham, through whom his seed will come, and his seed who have us to be saved. We thank you for whatever we have gone through the scriptures. We thank you for the narratives. We thank you, Father, for the steps. And we thank you for where we have ended now. So far, where we have reached shows us that Moses is the man you selected to take Israel from the hand of Pharaoh and to bring them back to Canaan land and to wait for the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, Father. We thank you and we glorify your name. And we thank you also for Moses, whom you spoke to him to let the people of Israel and the whole world know that it was Moses you chose early on, but now you have chosen another person who is Jesus Christ, through whom we can come to you. We glorify your name, Father, at this juncture for this great name and this great person. We thank you, Father, and we pray that you help us that we may be able to know your will through him, and that we may be able to do your will. After having known your will, we pray that you help us to do your will so that we don't get lost in the end. Forgive us of all our sins, Father, because we accept before you that we are sinful beings. We need your forgiveness. We need your encouragement. We need your strength. We need your knowledge. We need your everything for our survival. Forgive us, Father, and help us as we continue to glorify your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jamaica to you with love and with great taste. It's Tasty Patty Baker and Grill for the most delicious food you've ever tasted. Try the curry goat, so mouth-watering you must have more than one. Also the curry chicken, jerk chicken, stew cow foot. Try the escovitch fish, brown stew fish, and many other taste good dishes. All served with rice and peas or white rice. And check out also the soup of the day. You want a patty? Try the Angus beef, Allen chicken, salmon fish, and veggie patties. You love all of them. Tasty Patty Baker and Grill also has cakes, birthday cakes, fruit cakes, red velvet cakes, and photo cakes with your picture right on the cake. Sample their hard dough bread, Trini Mongoose bread, sweet bread, and other delectable breads and rolls. Tasty also has Nick's Barbados bread, such as tennis rolls, lead pipe, and other favorites. And don't forget the Jackass corn. Remember that? Yes, they have it. Jackass corn at Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill. It's many islands, one people, one love. At Tasty Patty Bakery and Grill, the home of good taste, located at 3122 Church Avenue, 1431 Rockaway Parkway, and 1371 Fulton Street, all in Brooklyn.
Take care of your body. If you don't take care of yourself, who will take care of you? So get Dr. Robert Brand Blood and Body Bitters. Dr. Robert's Red Blood Tonic fights off fat, cholesterol, itchy skin, and it nourishes the body to improve blood circulation. Liver Gin and Binding Amar contributes to keep the liver and blood healthy from toxin and the effects of diabetic and blood pressure medicines. Get Nervogen Tonic Powder, which helps to strengthen the nerves, brains, muscles, and even fosters better sleep. Dr. Robert's Diabetic Tonic helps to reduce blood sugar. Dr. Robert's Brand Flaxseed Oil Capsules and Cordyceps contributes to healthy skin, healthier hair, body, face, and even provides a younger look and reduces cholesterol. Get Trout Hall brand Carrot Nectar and Mama Haiti brand Mango Nectar, full with more fruits and fibers than the other watered-down brands. Demand Dr. Robert's high-quality teas and products in order to enjoy great quality and save at the same time. Always purchase Tip Top Circle Cheese. Yes, Tip Top Circle Cheese makes 8 delicious sandwiches. Just add a little mustard and hot sauce in the Tip Top Cheese. On sale now in most West Indian food stores and supermarkets, or by wholesale through AFN Brokers 908-486-0077 or IMP Food at 25.